Testing. Probably would help if I had a mirror so I can actually see what I'm doing. Okay, 8 years later. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. Oh my god, this took a hot minute to set up. I'm using my good external microphone, so I don't know. It's usually good at canceling out noise, but my dog is currently eating, so if you can hear him chomping, I apologize. And also, I'm hoping that there's not a really bad echo. I'm just trying my best here, okay? And of course, I'm doing this with like a little bit of a time crunch. I got an hour before I need to head out the door, so I think we'll be good. But I am about to get ready. I just got home from work a little while ago, and I am going to dinner with some of my friends. I'm actually gonna be the fifth wheel. Love that for me. But I figured it's been a while since I've just done like a sit down chatty video, and I thought, why not just record as I'm getting ready and let's do a Q&A. I asked you guys on Instagram last night if you had any questions for me, and I got a lot of responses. Thank you very much for that, by the way. Before we jump into the questions though, I did want to give a shout out to the sponsor of this video, Dossier. If you've been watching me for a while, you know this is my go-to. Ambery Saffron from Dossier. I wear it every single day. Sometimes I'll switch it up and do something different, but it's always Dossier. All of my perfumes at this point are from Dossier. They make replicas of brand name, well-known designer fragrances, but they are in simpler packaging without the retailer markups, celebrity marketing, all of the things that make the exact same perfume so much more expensive. So Dossier is able to offer their perfumes in some cases 70 to 90% less. So you're getting the exact same thing, same high quality, but for way less money. I just don't understand why you wouldn't. And personally, I like the look of the simpler packaging. I think it looks really nice on my dresser, and having multiple bottles that all look the same, it's very aesthetically pleasing rather than having like a bunch of different bottles that are all different shapes and colors. But yeah, the Ambery Saffron, like I said, is my favorite. It's been my go-to one for over 2 years now. It is a dupe or a replica of the Baccarat Rouge 540 perfume, which is very expensive. But because I get this from Dossier and it is so much more affordable, I can wear it every single day and not feel as guilty about it. And I'm telling you, this lasts on me all day long. I am constantly getting complimented on a regular basis. People are always asking me what perfume I'm wearing. If you guys want to check them out, I will have a link and a discount code in the description. They are now also available at Walmart, so you can shop in store or online if you would prefer to do that. I know that it's easier to be able to actually like test out a perfume in person first, but if you do order it online, Dossier has a really good return policy. But if you have like a go-to signature scent and you're normally buying like the brand name version of it, I highly recommend go check out Dossier, see if they have a replica for it, and start getting it from there, because you are gonna save yourself so much money. Thank you so much, Dossier, for continuing to work with me. They are like one of my longest running sponsorships, and they've been a huge supporter of my channel, and I love working with them because I really genuinely love these perfumes, and I've turned everyone in my personal life onto them, and I know a lot of you guys now are Dossier fans as well. So let me pull up the questions. I'm not going to talk much about the makeup that I'm using, but I will link everything in order in the description. Okay, first question, where would your dream vacation be? Ooh, I don't really know, honestly. I don't know, just off the top of my head right now, I would say like an all-inclusive resort in a tropical location, either with a group of my girlfriends or with a sexy man would be really nice. How to make friends after moving? I'm struggling. Now that I am back to working in a salon, I've been able to make friends through work. But if you are in a situation like I was when I first moved here, where you work from home, I would say go on social media. Facebook has a lot of local groups that you can join. Before I started working at the salon, I actually made a lot of friends through Instagram, oddly enough. Like, if you just look under the location, like the geotag of your town, you can just scroll through the pictures on there, and if you see somebody that looks like you'd be friends with them, go to their page, see if they actually live in the same town as you, and if they do, follow them. Maybe, you know, comment on a picture, send them a DM, and just be like, oh, hey, this might be kind of weird, but I'm new to the area, and I came across your page. I saw that you also live in the same town. I don't know. You can, like, kind of become social media friends with them first, and then maybe ask to, like, meet them for coffee or something. Obviously, be careful and smart about it, but... Or you can also try, like, Bumble BFF. I tried that when I first moved here, but nothing ended up coming of it. But that's always an option too. I don't know, you gotta kind of just put yourself out there. And I know it can be a little uncomfortable sometimes, especially if you're not like naturally an extroverted person. I wish you the best of luck, and I'm sure you will make friends eventually. It just takes a little bit of time. Oh, how's your love life? I don't know. It is so complicated. I don't even know what to say. If you listen to my podcast, which, by the way, I have a podcast with my friend Julia. It's called Girls Who Get It Podcast. I will link it down below. I was talking in a recent episode about how my ex was in town visiting me. So, trying to figure out that whole situation. I'm honestly not really sure what I want or what is right for me, who's right for me. It's like one of those things where I want to talk about it online sometimes because I feel like it could be really relatable and possibly helpful for me too, to like get some insight and like third party opinions. But at the same time, it's such a personal thing too, and it involves another person, and I feel weird like sharing that publicly. But if I do end up talking about it more, it most likely will be on my podcast. So please go subscribe to that. It'll be linked in the description. Like I said, we have a YouTube channel, and we're also on Apple Podcasts and Spotify. But yeah, other than that, like, the love life is pretty dry. I'm not like currently dating. I was on the apps again for like a hot second, but that very quickly got discouraging, and don't have any apps on my phone right now, and I'm not actively looking for anything or dating or anything like that. I'm just living my life. I just try to enjoy being on my own. I will say having my ex here did make me realize how much I appreciate my personal space and like my alone time and living by myself. So yeah, I'm just trying to enjoy that for as long as I can and let the universe do what it needs to do, and, you know, whatever is meant to be will be, kind of thing. How do you stay motivated while working from home? Oof. I don't know. I don't. I really don't. I have such a hard time with that. Actually, before I ever went to cosmetology school, I did online marketing and like social media management, and we had the option to work from home, and I just couldn't do it. Like, as much as I wanted to stay home, I chose to go into the office every day, because when I stayed home, I just had such a hard time holding myself accountable and staying motivated. I think with doing YouTube, it's a little bit different because I'm working for myself and I don't follow a super strict schedule. Unless I have like a brand deal and it's due by a certain time. I do think though, like, having a designated office space in your home helps, and like sticking to a strict routine and like getting ready and pretending like you're actually going into the office. Because I feel like for me, if I'm just like sitting on the couch and I stay in my pajamas, I'm not gonna be in work mode and I'm not gonna wanna actually like get stuff done. What made you start YouTube, and was it a slow start? It definitely was a slow start. I've been on YouTube now for 10 years, and I mean, even now my channel's not big. I'm considered like a small influencer still. What made me want to start was I was in college at the time and I was just feeling very lost, and I was having a hard time like adjusting to the college life. I didn't really want to be there, and YouTube was just my creative outlet. So I would just do it like in between classes in my bedroom. Would you ever move back to PA? I don't think so. I was actually just talking to my friend earlier today about this. My family, like my immediate family at the moment, is still in Pennsylvania, but my mom, even way before I moved down here, she always said that she was gonna move down south. She's just like waiting to retire, basically. So her plan was never to stay there anyway. And then the rest of my family is like spread out all over the place. So there's really no reason, like once my parents move out of Pennsylvania, there's nothing there for me. There's no, like, yeah, I have friends, I guess, but there's no reason for me to move back there. How's your fitness journey going? It's going well. I have been consistently working out now since the beginning of January. I will say I've been having a little bit of a tough time staying like super strict throughout summer because I've been traveling a lot. I've had friends come and stay with me and we've just been going out a lot. You know, there's been a lot of like going out to eat, drinking, stuff like that. And I've been very conflicted with like, do I force myself to stay strict or do I just enjoy my summer and enjoy my life? But like, I've still been exercising and I feel really good. I feel strong, I feel healthy. I actually just went to the gym earlier today. So it's going well. I am looking forward though, like once summer's over, I really wanna like kick it into high gear and get stricter again, especially with my nutrition. A bunch of questions about dating. How's dating going? Are you dating at the moment? Definitely, I'm telling you, subscribe to my podcast if you aren't already, because any of those kinds of updates that I ever have, you will hear them first on the podcast. What do you find is the hardest thing to do in the hair industry? Love your videos, by the way. Thank you so much. Honestly, the hardest thing is dealing with people. Because I feel like any of the technical stuff, you can practice and you can get better at it. But the dealing with people never gets easier. Because even if you get better at it and you have a lot of experience and you know how to handle certain situations, I feel like you never fully become numb to it when you have like a difficult client or somebody that's just really mean or inconsiderate. How has your mental health been lately? Aw, I like that question. And I appreciate you asking. My mental health has been really good. I mean, don't get me wrong. Like, I have my bad days, obviously. I was just kind of going through it the last few days and I was kind of having a rough time. But I would say overall, it's been really good. And this is also why I have no intention of moving back north anytime soon, because I feel like ever since I moved down here, the weather affects me so much. And I always thought that, but to actually see it in action is a crazy thing. Like, I would get really bad seasonal depression, but ever since I moved down here, that has not happened to me. And I definitely, like, in the first, I would say, 6 months of living here, it's been almost 2 years now. December will be 2 years, if you can believe it. It's crazy how fast time flies. But the first 6 months were hard and my anxiety was the worst it's ever been in my whole life. But I think it was just from like all the big life changes. You know, I went through a breakup. I moved 600 miles away from all of my close friends and my family, to a place where I didn't know anyone and I didn't know what was gonna happen, how I was gonna adjust, how I was gonna like it here. I was taking a break from hair at the time and I was trying to decide like what I wanted to do career-wise. It was just a lot of change all at once. But now that I've adjusted and I feel like everything is in order, I have a good routine, I have a full life here, I feel great. So I've been good. Would you ever get Benny a puppy sibling? Aw. Well, that was running low and now it just got all over my dress and like barely anything got on my face. So that's cool. Love that for me. Whatever, it'll dry. Yeah, I really would love to. Like, I could totally see myself with like 5 dogs. honestly. But not anytime soon, because right now I'm just in a little one bedroom apartment. It's like 600 square feet. It's very tight in here. So it would just be like way too cramped. When the time comes that I eventually have a house with a backyard, ideally a fenced in backyard, I absolutely would love to get another dog. How has your no birth control journey been? It's been great. I've been off the pill. Actually, this month made 2 years since I stopped taking it. I was on the birth control pill for many, many years. I stopped taking it at one point in college because it was always making me nauseous. And then I had all these terrible symptoms. Stopped getting a period, was breaking out like crazy. And so my gynecologist like basically scared me into getting back on it because she wasn't really offering much help. She was just kind of like, yeah, I think you have PCOS, so you have to get back on the pill. And then I finally just bit the bullet 2 years ago and I stopped taking it, and I haven't had any negative symptoms and I've felt amazing. And I can just feel myself getting more in tune with my body, and I can feel that my body is working the way it's supposed to. Like, my periods are so regular. It comes exactly like every 28 days. And I don't get period cramps anymore. And my periods are like pretty light and they're not super long. And now I recently, like within the last few months, I can feel when I'm ovulating. Like, for a while I would get symptoms, like I could tell it was happening, but now I can straight up feel it, and I can feel like which side I'm ovulating from. It's crazy. And I always would hear women say that. I knew that that was a possibility, but I had never experienced it. And obviously when you're on the pill, you're not ovulating. So yeah, it's really crazy how everything is just like working the way it's supposed to now. I love it. I feel amazing. It's a little tricky as far as like, you know, preventing pregnancy, but because my period is so regular, I can track and I know like when I'm fertile and when I'm not. Not that it matters, because I am single and not seeing anybody, so. Last time you had sex. Wow. Okay, that's really hilarious after we were just talking about this. Well, my ex was here, like I said, so. But prior to that, it had been like 8 months. What do you think about one night stands? Have you done it? I get attached. It's too personal. I have done it. Also, sorry to my mom, who I know is watching right now. I have nothing against it. Like, I do you, you know? As long as whatever you're doing is consensual, you're not hurting anybody, you're being safe, you're being smart, do whatever you want to do, do what makes you happy. But for me, at this point in my life, I'm kind of over that. And honestly, like, let's be real. If you're hooking up with somebody that you don't really know, they don't care to make it good. Like, as women, you know, it takes more for most of us anyway to like enjoy the experience. And if you're just with, I mean, I guess there are some guys that like they will put in that effort, but I feel like a lot of the times, if it's just like a one-time thing, they don't know you, they don't really care about you, like they're just being selfish and they're just worried about getting themselves off. So it's like, it's probably not even gonna be that good for you. So what's even the point? You could have just like stayed home with a toy and not risk an STD or pregnancy. And that's my thing too. Like, I'm so paranoid all of a sudden lately about STDs. So I'm just like, ugh. Let's do one last question. I also am kind of like losing daylight here. So have you ever had a friend breakup because of a disagreement or something shady? I've had two friend breakups. The first one happened in high school, and I don't even really remember if there was like a big event that occurred that caused us to stop being friends. I think it was just kind of like a gradual thing. We just kind of like drifted and were butting heads a lot. But then we reconnected in college and we never, like, we were best friends for years. And we never got back to that same place. Because I think as we got older, we just really became very different people. So we're not nearly as close as we used to be, but we are still friends. And then the other one, again, we have been friends forever. And we actually last year kind of got into it. And it was just kind of like a combination of things. I just kind of got to a point where I feel like, especially when you have your friends that you've known since like childhood, you just kind of keep them around and you tolerate things. Like, even if they're not the greatest friend to you and they don't really treat you that well, or maybe you don't really love the way they treat other people or just the way they are as a person, but you just kind of keep them around anyway because they've been in your life forever and you don't really think much of it. But like, if you were to just meet them now at this point in your life, you probably wouldn't be friends with them or not as close anyway. That's kind of what the situation was like. And I kind of got to a point where I was like, you're kind of being an asshole. It wasn't like one specific thing. It was just kind of like a combination of things that had built up for a while. And I also just kind of felt like she wasn't putting in the same kind of effort that I was putting into our friendship. I felt like if it wasn't for me, we wouldn't even really be friends anymore. Friend breakups are almost as bad as relationship breakups. But I think that's important, especially as you get older. It's like, why are you gonna make time in your life for people that don't deserve it and don't deserve to be in your life? You know, like, I am really trying to honor my peace, and I feel like in order for you to be a part of my inner circle, you have to really earn that. But anyway, there were still a bunch of questions left, so if you guys would like me to do another Q&A soon, let me know. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed this, and don't forget to check the description for my link and discount code to Dossier. And I will see you really soon in my next video. Bye.